Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Lehigh Mountain Hawks and the Xavier Musketeers. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
Hey, Brad, check out the power forwards. These kids are fun to watch. They've got enough skill level to carry their respective teams to victory.
All right, guys, we're in position and we're ready for the tip. Xavier takes the tip and starts up the floor. Puts up the runner. Not there. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
They work the perimeter. And the block. Goes in.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
Trying to feed the low block. Takes his jumper off the mark. Gave it up. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. In the post, goes up for two, drains the shot. The Musketeers looking to attack in transition. For the bucket, off the glass and no good. On the outside, number 32 is seemingly at an emotional low right now.
He needs for something positive to happen, which will light his fire and get him going.
And come up short.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Had his shot rejected. On the dribble, gives it up. Blocked. Nice job defensively.
Look at that spacing.
Let's it fly. Can't connect. The wing. In the lane. Missed the jumper. Nice shot. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Pushes it up. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
On the right side. Takes the jumper. Dick, are they being taken out of their game offensively?
Hey, they're taking themselves out of the game by rushing bad shots and not executing an offense.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from outside. Jumper won't go. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For two. Knocks it down. He may be in some trouble here. And a momentary look from three-point land. We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk, lift their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down. And I think right now, got to focus defensively.
They work it around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move. Number 40 takes the feed. He misses the fadeaway. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Number 3 picks up the layup, counts and the foul.
He went hard to the hoop knowing he was going to get fouled.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. They have one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. Experience is so important, Brad. See situations and knowing how to react to them correctly and quickly is a great, great thing.
They've got him right where they want him, Richard.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Moving it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Peterson receives the pass. Wolf keeps it in. Out on the left wing. He takes the shot. And he missed. They'll work it around the arc. Three. Nails a sweet jumper. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
Looking for a good shot. He puts up the J. Off the mark. working it around the perimeter. Puts up the J. Nope. He cleans the glass.
Up it inside.
He tries a jump hook.
Watch, I didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. Stolen away. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Loose ball kept in. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
I tell you, as a coach, Brad, it's always nice to have a player surprisingly step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward.
So the inbound play on the baseline. The Musketeers go into their zone motion now. Missed it. A little two-man action. In the paint. Tries for two. You betcha. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
Well, those aggressive moves to the basket are what this offense is all about.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
They work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds. Off the glass and no good. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Nice hops.
7 minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. He fades away. He misses the fadeaway. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They work the perimeter. He tries the three ball. The missed shot. Receives the ball. On the outside. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. For the bucket. Can't put it down. Way out on the right wing. Now trying to feed the low block. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Pushes it up. Shoots from the top of the circle. 10 seconds.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Double team now. Bad angle.
Goes up with a shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty. I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Gave it up. He wants a three. Off the mark. They look to get it to the inside with the J and come up short.
Look at that spacing.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
About 4 minutes remaining. Wolf receives the pass. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. He drains the bucket. It in. Goes up for two. That's good. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read.
Cross court.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
3 minutes left on the game clock. Going to move it around the perimeter. He pulls the trigger. Can't connect. Number 21 gets the ball. Trying to pack it inside for the bucket. Off the glass. They get that rejected. Comes up empty. This is the easy one. Number 3 takes the pass. Goes up with it. Gets the J to fall. We're at the 2 minute mark. Momentary look from three-point land. Jumper. They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
Hey, when you get in a funk like this, you've got to get a few gimmies, some layups, something that's going to get your rhythm back and give you the confidence to shoot from the perimeter.
Low block. He attempts the jump shot. Knocks it down. My, oh, my, this is turning out to be one tough place to play for the visitors, Nick.
Hey, the home team crowd is starting to get crazy, Brad, and that spells trouble for the visitors. Hey, when this place gets going, it's one of the toughest places to play in the country.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Misses the second. Number 3 takes the pass. 1 minute left to go. The shooting guard with the ball. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Out on the wing.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Here they go in transition. Number 3 takes the feed. for two. Nails the J. Shot clock is dead. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. He gets that one to fall. Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. With the big shot, he can't get the hoop to fall. At the end of the first half, the Mountain Hawks are up by one. Xavier, looks like they're shooting blanks from the floor, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, they're missing tons of field goal opportunities, and it's shocking for this ball club. It's time for them to go back to the drawing boards and talk things over.
Number 32 subs back into the thick of things, Dick.
Hey, you can't keep a guy like this out for too long, Brad. He's just too valuable.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Seconds.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. There it is, Jam City.
There's a double team waiting there. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
He puts up the tray, missed the jumper. Ross receives the pass. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Moving it around the perimeter. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
They'll work it around the arc. With the jumper. Jumper won't go. Looking for a good shot. The fadeaway. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up. Scores it. He may be in some trouble here. He can't get around the trap.
Are you kidding me? He tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Brad.
For the deuce. He makes the shot. Gave it up. Going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge.
The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. They go into the low block. Takes the jumper. The missed shot, swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Nice pass to the low block. Off the mark. Misses the jumper. Price handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the jumper. Missed it. He gets it to go. That one went through the high post, Dick.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Escapes a trap.
He wasn't afraid of that trap.
Baseline. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Out on the wing. Down inside. For the bucket. The shot's off target. Number three handles the feed. Working it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Busts the jumper. They'll bring it back out on top and reset it.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. I hate it when guys can't make that entry.
Inside. Ten seconds.
Up and inside.
For two. Scorches the net. Puts up the J.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He shoots the jumper. Busts the J. That trap could spell some trouble. They've got him right where they want him, Richard. Tries for two. He buries it. They're working around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Sinks the shot. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
Yeah, one thing on his mark, and that was getting to the goal. Mission accomplished.
On the outside. His jumper. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game. It's always a treat to watch.
Gave it up. He just threw it out of bounds. The Musketeers have come out here and they're really focused on sharing the ball and really playing pretty good defense, Dick.
You know, everyone's been getting involved. Passing, rebounding, taking the ball to the hoop. A great team effort will always keep a team in it.
The Musketeers move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Out on the wing. Goes up with it. Nope. He grabs the rebound. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Got it. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time. Trying to go inside.
He puts up the J.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
They work the perimeter. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
They look like they're having a blast.
Gets it to go. Outside. Let's watch the move as he works his man and not a fadeaway jumper. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
And yet another missed field goal attempt.
Hey, when you get in a funk like this, you've got to get a few gimmies, some layups, something that's going to get your rhythm back and give you the confidence to shoot from the perimeter.
Musketeers should consider switching their current tempo and mindset to more of a half-court game. With the time and score on their side, that seems to make sense to me, Dick.
Hey, with the lead, they have to really focus on defense and defensive stops. The goal now should be to run sets and keep the clock from stopping.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Let's take another look at our star watch. The Mountain Hawks might be in trouble here, Dick. It might be time to abandon any half-court sets and look at getting some baskets in transition.
Hey, Brad, they have to increase the tempo and start pressing. Basically, do the things they aren't used to doing. Their backs are against the wall.
There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Trap could spell some trouble. Great trap. They managed to keep the defender in check.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Here they go in transition. For two, he doesn't get the hoop to fall. I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
It's crazy in here, Brad.
The point guard receives the ball. 6 minutes left on the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too, when he goes up and under. He seals off the defensive player.
Stolen.
Look at that spacing.
He strips him clean. The point guard handles the feed. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
He looks for three. Nails the sweet jumper. Game to game, Dick, what might we expect from a half-court oriented team?
I think you need players who really understand the game and know how to get others open, as well as use screens. Typically, they aren't the most athletic guys.
Off the mark. Looking for a good shot. He attempts the trifecta off the glass. The point guard gets the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He takes the shot, and he missed. The point guard receives the ball. Four minutes left on the game clock. On the left side, from downtown, nails the J. Momentary look from three-point land. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
Hey, pandemonium is in full effect.
And come up short. Number three handles the pass. Here they come with a double team to stop it. Puts up the jumper. Nails the J. Turnaround jumper. They're really losing confidence with their poor shooting at the time, Dick.
Hey, nothing that a couple of fast break dunks could cure.
Fed the low block.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
They run it up into transition. Got it. Great trap initiated by the defense. Pushes it up. Tries for two. He doesn't get the hook. Here they come now on a turnover. Hard foul. He gets the foul and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
He's been around for a couple of years now. He knows what he's capable of bringing to the team. This is the year when players start to transition into more of a leadership role and help get the most out of younger guys on the team.
That trap could spell some trouble. Pushes it up. Goes up for two, lays it up. About 2 minutes remaining. They're working around the perimeter. Let's it fly. He misses the J. Peterson receives the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Bust the jumper.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He goes up with it. The missed shot. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Number 55 walking back out onto the floor.
He needs to get himself warm playing defense first before he starts to think about offense.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. Now here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
Second shot.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
He attempts to dribble around the trap, unsuccessful though.
Well done, great trap.
That's a foul. Number 13 coming in for the first time tonight.
He will give this defense a different kind of threat at this position. Smart move.
Steps to the line for an easy one.
Gets the first shot.
Number 32 steps out onto the court.
Hey, that can't go too long without his presence. Like me, I can't go long without you.
Second shot, good.
And Dick, that puts the lead at 9.
9 points is surmountable. This is the time to start jacking threes.
Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. Visit the charity stripe.
No doubt about it.
He misses it. On the dribble, gives it up. Loose ball, kept in. And we've got a change in possession here. Number 13 gets in on the action for the first time tonight.
He has a great presence when he steps on the floor, Brad.
And the clock stopped with a foul. He goes to the line for the first time.
Makes the front end of the 1-1. He can't buy one.
Alston receives the ball. Gave it up. And we've got a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. Get ready to bounce back into action here. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the three and off the mark. He goes to the line for the first time.
First shot is good. Makes both of them.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Chance for an easy one.
Hits the first. Second shot, no good.
Pushes it up. Who wants it? And he saves it.
The point guard gets the pass.
Moving it around the perimeter. Xavier wins the game.
They expected to be the victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.